Hi, this is Janet, and I'm here with Herbie on Flash.
Edit.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Janet Jackson est la cadette de ce qu'on pourrait appeler la famille royale du pop. Depuis l'âge de 5 ans qu'elle évolue sur scène, la jeune femme s'est bien transformée.
I'm gonna be a big star.
Avec All For You, son dernier album, elle est plus épanouie que jamais.
You're sexier than ever.
Oh, thanks.
But you're saying that you don't feel sexy. You don't think you're sexy.
I'm just an okay gal, kind of, sort of. But see, I mean, there are a lot of people that I find very sexy, but I don't see myself in that class at all.
Who do you find sexy?
Oh, God, I think Benicio del Toro is sexy. What have you done for me lately? Angelina Jolie's sexy. Nasty, nasty boy. I think Denzel's sexy. You want me to keep going?
You get to meet them. Do you tell them? I think you're sexy.
No, are you kidding? I'm too embarrassed.
Because you're single now, so you're dating.
Yeah,
so
but
you're still allowed now to tell them.
No, it's embarrassing.
Janet est une fille timide, mais pourtant, sur son dernier album, elle n'hésite pas à aborder des sujets en bas de la ceinture.
Some sensual things, experiences. Great experiences that I had to sing about because they were so incredible.
About sex.
Exactly, that's what I'm talking about.
You're talking about a guy's package in one of the songs. How important is the size for you?
Very. Yeah. It's about the fit, so whatever is right for them. So it is about the size. Whatever works for you.
Et depuis son divorce avec René Elizondo, Janet a-t-elle trouvé un homme à sa mesure?
You mean, do I have a guy?
Yeah.
No. I mean, there are a few people that I've been dating, but nothing that serious.
Do you realize that you're the most secretive person in show business?
I am.
Were married for 10 years.
Oh, I guess I am.
And
yeah.
Nobody knew until you got divorced. That's good. In Hollywood, that's good.
Yeah, I think it's really good. And if René wouldn't have said anything, no one still would have known.
Are you mad at him for that?
No. There was a time when I was upset at that because I felt it came from hurt. And him feeling such pain, he wanted me to feel pain as well. So that I thought was not a nice thing to do.
You're talking like you still love him.
I do. I do. That's the problem. I'm not in love with him, but I do love René, and I wish him the best.
Une autre personne qu'elle continue d'aimer inconditionnellement, c'est bien sûr son frère Michael.
So what's your relationship with Michael? Because people are saying they're not talking, they're talking.
Oh, that's crap. It's not that. There's love and there's closeness, and there are no animosities. We just don't talk a lot to each other. And
why?
Growing up, we were very close. Everybody's just very busy, and I know that's no excuse, and some of us aren't callers. And that still isn't an excuse, but unfortunately, that's the way some of us are.
Alors, fera-t-elle partie du concert retour de Michael et ses frères en septembre prochain?
Oh, God, no. I mean, he called me about that, and unfortunately...
He asked you to perform?
Yeah.
And you said no?
No, I didn't say no.
Okay.
I wanted to, but unfortunately, I start my tour in July. He called
could
me
cancel
like,
it. It's gonna be Michael and all your brothers. It's a family thing.
It's a family affair, but it's not quite that easy.
Yeah, I know.
Unfortunately.
I'm just playing with you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
L'imitateur Laurent Gérard est une superstar.